Respected Srimati Nirmala Ji Sitaraman Garu, Honorable Minister, Defence Government of India, Mananiya Sri Suresh Ji Soni, Sarkaryavah Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, Sri BVR Mohan Reddy Garu, Siant Vice Chairman Garu, Sri TRSP Raju Garu, President Samskruti Foundation, Sri Varaprasad Reddy Garu, distinguished invitees, esteemed sisters, pranams to all of you. It is my fortune and privilege to welcome you all to this great event. I, on behalf of the reception committee, express our gratitude to all of you for having spared time to this a rare and exceptional event, and which can be said to be a turning point for anybody whoever takes it seriously. There are three prominent speakers. It would not be proper on my part to take any long time, but as a person who is occupying the dais, let it not be thought that a chair on the dais has been wasted for a person who did not speak at all. Today's theme, the re-emergence of India, that is Bharat, and role of the fifth estate. In the handout, the details of all the estates are given. Even initially, I too thought, what is this fifth estate? Three estates, three pillars, executive, legislature, and judiciary are provided in the constitution itself. And over a period, the press and media has been accorded the status of another pillar. And this fifth estate or fifth pillar is identified as the culture. My view, personally, and I don't know how far you will agree with me, that if one takes into account the way the other four pillars have been functioning for the past 70 years, time has come when this fifth pillar should be treated as the first pillar, and a structure, all through we have seen this fourth pillar structure. Now we have to have a structure like a circus dera, where the tall pillar is the in between, that is our this culture, and rest of the four are all around. It is only then that a country can become great. Any country, whatever its origin is and whatever its position in the globe is, will clamor for its own culture. But India is a country which is endowed with the culture spread over thousands of years. If anybody had any doubt, because our education is, our progressive scholars have created a lot of doubt in us regarding our own culture. And if that doubt is there, our Honorable President of, former President of India, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, has removed all that doubt in his speech given day before yesterday. What a great culture it was. It withstood all the foreign invasions and all that. Unfortunately, after independence, a section of society branding themselves as progressive and advanced thinkers have virtually brought a curtain on our culture and made us to doubt our own origin, our own this thing. For example, our scriptures contain everything which is superlative in its content. Take mathematics, take chemistry, alchemy, every field of study. A great scientist like Sir Albert Einstein acknowledged that had it not been the invention of zero in India, today's science would not have progressed. Like that, everybody acknowledged it. But what? And in Taittiriya Upanishad, we get a detailed account of the convocation on completion of studies. It is in the convocation they are reminded of the values. Satyam Vada, Dharmam Chara, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, and what you should do to the society and what you should not do. And what is today's convocation? It is symbolized just by throwing up a hat into the air and followed by some campaign, champagne or drinking all sorts of nonsensical things. And our greatness is not in a way. Recently, I have read an article written by Michael Denino. He said, I am not going to take much of your time, I will wind up within 2 minutes. He said, India is the only country where the progressive thinkers doubt anything great of their own country. Recently, I have been to Chennai in the context of selecting a vice chancellor for an esteemed university, Alagappa University. One of the shortlisted candidates was a historian. I asked him, sir, what is your opinion about Ramasetu, particularly in the context of a recent report by NASA, who have conducted research in their own way. He said, no, we can't believe that. Just scientific analysis will not do. They should convince our people, then only we can recognize it to be a historical monument. That is the level of a PhD scholar in the Department of History. And what sort of historians we have got? I had an occasion to recently go through a book, Makers of Modern India. And it is circulated to all establishments in the government during the previous years. And what does it contain? It contains about 20 or 30 names. Rashid Alvi, some person who was in charge of conversions in Northeast, Sir Sayyid Ahmed, Indira Gandhi, so many persons, all these things. And they are the makers of India. But the author was so honest, though pervert. He said, I omitted the names of Sardar Patel, Swami Vivekananda, and Subhash Chandra Bose. The reason is that they did not leave anything original of their own. Rashid Alvi left, but not Subhash Chandra Bose. And some other, Sir Sayyid Ahmed left something, but not Sardar Patel. Like that is the type of historians, properly called historians, we have got. And all our textbooks are full of these distortions. And this can be remedied only by a sense of nationalism and patriotism. And we are really happy to know that a personality like Sir Sri Pranab Mukherjee virtually has said that there is not much of a difference between nationalism and patriotism. I'll only conclude by drawing an example about it. In the course of hearing in the OROP issue, in Jammu, there was a presentation by senior veterans. One gentleman who retired from army was aged about 80 years. He was saying, my granddaughter asked me, Grandpa, what is patriotism? And he said, see, if not today, after 5 years or 6 years, I will die. And my body is put on a pyre and somebody will lift it. If my body is half burnt and a message comes that some foreign invasion is taking place, right on the pyre, I will rise and take 2 firewoods and go to war from there. That is patriotism. And what is the sense of dedication? Recently, there was a Sanskrit language related presentation, in that there was a small playlet, in that a mother had 3 sons. All of them are in armed forces. War takes place, serious operations were going on. The first one son died. His body was brought to the village. People surrounded, the cremation was taking place. Mother was unmoved. People were astonished. Why that mother is not weeping at all? Then after some days, the second son died. Same thing happened. When third son died in the war and his body was brought, at that time the mother weeps. And people ask, why that you did not weep when two sons died and why is that you are weeping at them? She said, I am weeping because I did not have fourth son who could have fought the war. That is the sense of belonging, that is the sense of dedication. When Ustad Bismillah Khan, a noted Shehnai, his son was settled in England. When his son insisted that, Baba, why not you come to England because your age and all that, why don't you live with me? His answer was, Beta, mai wahan aaye to yahan mera Vishwanath ko kaun jagayega? And our people say, every day our these three estates, judiciary not excluded, and our fourth estate, they make every effort to draw a line between on religious lines. Let me give you one example in one sentence. One Pavani Seva Samiti, they conduct this competition in the chanting of verses. In Guntur district, they distributed Dasharathi Shatakam in Telugu, full of Ramayana, and conducted a competition. One Muslim girl stood first. And the prize to be given was a portrait of Lord Sita Ramachandraji. These people were in a doubt. Parents, the girl gave, the girl was there. And if you give it that, they may not feel comfortable. Then they ask, see, this is the worth of this prize. If you ask, we will give some other prize which is suitable to you. The parents and girl said, Hame khali Bhagavan Ram ka chahiye kisi dusre ka nahi. That is the thing. And if we want to remove all this nonsensical curtain which is put on our culture, it is only this, not fifth estate, but first estate, that is culture. Thank you very much. Let us sing.